This is Prittlewell Chapel in Westcliff-on-Sea, Southend, and this is the second Build With Care film to keep you updated on how the project is going to bring the chapel back to its former glory and at the same time make it a beacon of energy efficiency. As this is an update film, let's get an update from the man on the ground, site manager Phil Girling.
Yeah, been quite a lot of stuff going on site since last time. The scissor trusses have all been fitted. The rafters have been fitted on top of the scissor truss. The roof's starting to have the covering put over it. All the slates on parts of the roof. We're continuing on with the repairs to the central spire. The structural works are nearly finished on that. The sandblasters have been on site, cleaning up all this brickwork and the stonework. It's great now, it looks like a new building. Stonework repairs are ongoing, the masons are on site, coping stones are going back on, they're starting to do repairs around the windows and some of the brickwork. They're starting to take shape now.
One of the questions that has been asked by local residents is how is this energy efficient building going to be used? To find out, we talked to the people who are going to be running the building for the next 20 years.
I'm Alison Simmons, I'm the Chief Officer of SAVS, which is Southend Association of Voluntary Services. It's going to be used for the community. There's two rooms. One room will be used as a training room, meeting room, and the other room will have six desks where people, charities, community groups can come and hire that, probably on 6 month lets, so they can come and run their organisations from there.
The eco side of the building, how important is that to SAVS?
It's very important, especially in the current economic climate. We need to be able to run it as cheaply as possible. What I'm hoping is that we can operate it as much as possible from our building in Central Southend, so we can let people in and basically service it from here as much as possible. It's a unique building, it's beautiful. It's not the sort of building the voluntary sector normally has. It's going to be leased over to us on a 20-year lease from the council so that we can use it for the community.
The renovation of the Prittlewell Chapel is firmly based around the use of the latest energy-efficient technologies, many of which can be used in people's homes. One of the most important components of this is the air source heat pump, which will be used to heat the building. Now, we had no idea how this works, so we asked the man that does, project engineer Neil Poynter.
Right, air source heat pumps extracts heat from outside air, in a similar way to a fridge extracting its heat from inside. It extracts heat from the air even when the outside temperature is as low as minus 15, so it's quite a range. Heat from the air is absorbed into a fluid which is pumped through a heat exchanger within the unit. Low grade heat's then extracted by the refrigeration system, and after passing through the heat pump compressor, it's concentrated into a higher temperature which is useful heat, capable of heating the heating and the hot water.
The air source heat pump is very similar in some respects to an air conditioning unit. The process is very similar in the way that it operates. There will be an outside unit that will be situated over just behind us. That will just sit on a plinth and will operate at that point. We decided at quite an early stage to not go down the ground source heat route. Partly for space and partly for access of plant to get the original piles in. So the air source heat pumps are a nice compromise for us.
Will this save money?
Yes, definitely. Energy efficiency is the largest part of that. The unit that we'll be using has got a coefficient of power of about 4, which means for every kilowatt of electricity that we use, we produce 4 kilowatts of usable energy. That's going to serve not only our underfloor heating, but will also serve our hot water as well.
If somebody wanted to do it in their own house, is it reasonably easy to do if you have the money to do it?
If you have the money to do it, yes, it is very easy. And normally you'd couple it with an underfloor heating system. Most domestic properties don't have underfloor heating systems, so you do tend to drift into the larger properties where some of the more commercial applications tend to creep in. But they are, as a technology, a lot more popular nowadays, and you're seeing them encroach into a lot more schools, so the technology is being adopted quite a lot.
Build With Care's primary aim is the integration of energy-efficient technologies into all of our homes, and this is supported by Southend Borough Council, who told us why they're involved in this project.
Councillor Anna Waite, I'm the Executive Councillor for Housing, Health and Adult Services at Southend-on-Sea Borough Council. I think it's extremely important. It's right in the middle of one of the most deprived parts of the town, and I think for them to see that we are investing in their community is excellent. But more than that, it's important to the whole town because it's a gem of a building, and it's such a shame that it got to the state it got to. So now by investing in it, we're bringing it up to standard, and hopefully we're going to put a really good project in place for the residents that everybody can be proud of. And hopefully it will inspire other people who've got older properties to actually look at the antiquity of them and decide what's worth keeping, what needs to be replacing, and to go ahead and do a restoration rather than a demolition.
How important is this to Southend?
We're doing this to a much higher standard than we would normally do, and that is important because electricity, gas, power is only going to go upwards. And what we can show now by the beacon scheme like this, how you can save on those facilities, it's going to inspire others, I hope, to follow along and do similar things in their projects. And as somebody who's been involved with the Build With Care project, you know, this is what it's all about. This is learning from other technologies, what's going on in other towns and cities across Europe, not just in the UK, and learning from what they're doing and applying it to our own properties and benefiting for everybody as a result of that.
And if you want to know more about the work that's being done here, please go to the Southend Borough Council website, www.southend.gov.uk, and search for Build With Care.